Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today in this video, I am filming a Music Monday. I think this is the first one of 2017, so yay for Music Mondays being back. This Music Monday is going to be focused around performances that have happened, particularly in February or in 2017 so far, so like the Grammys, the Super Bowl, stuff like that, mostly just those two. But I wanted to include it. It's been about 2 weeks since the Grammys, and it's been about 3 weeks since the Super Bowl, and I have yet to talk about either one of them in a video on my main channel, at least. I do have a video of me reacting to the Super Bowl performance if you want to go watch it on my vlog channel, but I have not said anything about it on here yet, so I wanted to cover it in a Music Monday. Yeah, so we'll just go right ahead and get into it. First of all, I do also want to say I apologize for the audio in my last video. It was still pretty low. I have since adjusted it, so hopefully it's not too loud or too soft now. Hopefully it's just right now. And I also do want to mention that I still have not gotten the adapter for my mic mount, so I'm going to try and go and get that tomorrow. I want to go ahead and film my room tour video, but it's kind of hard to do it without a mic that stays on there. It just kind of rests on there, and I don't want my mic to break, obviously, so I've been trying to wait to do that. But regardless, I will be filming a room tour sometime in the beginning of March, and then since spring begins in March, I want to do like a kind of spring cleaning type declutter thing. I wanted to do a beginning of the year one, but of course my grandfather passed away and all that happened. So I'm going to do it in March, so I will be filming a room tour soon, and then some declutter series to try and get rid of some of the clutter in my room and do kind of like a spring cleaning of my room. So that will be coming for you guys. I just wanted to let you guys know. So Super Bowl, that's where I'm going to start because it happened first. It happened on the very first weekend in February, I believe, first or second weekend. 3 weeks from today, whatever that is. I don't know. I don't even know what today is. It's like the 26th or something. I don't know. 3 weeks from today was the Super Bowl. And first of all, I hate the Patriots. Just want to put that out there. This is not a football video or sports related video in any way, but I hate the Patriots, so I rooted for the Falcons. Luke Bryan, first of all, did the national anthem, which I love, love, love Luke Bryan, and I really hope that he does the halftime performance last year, because Lady Gaga did the national anthem last year at the Super Bowl, and then this year she played the halftime show. So maybe since Luke played the anthem this year, maybe next year he'll play the halftime show. I don't know what it is about me. I don't know if it's just because I was raised with such American pride, and I was born to a family of veterans, and just anytime I hear the national anthem, it just gives me chills, especially if it's somebody who can actually sing it well, and it really makes me happy and emotional and a whole world of feelings. But Luke Bryan's version was so good. It was a cappella. He just did amazing, and I just love Luke Bryan. Who doesn't love Luke Bryan? I want to talk about the halftime show a little bit. I tweeted about it. I also have a reaction video, so I won't say too much here, but I did want to mention it in a video. First of all, the intro to that, where she sang up on top of the stadium and had the stars behind her and like the flag behind her and stars, and then she jumped off, I was like, whoa, what just happened? Again, you can go watch the reaction video. I watched it with a bunch of guys who didn't really like Lady Gaga. They were not very big fans of Lady Gaga, which I don't know very many straight guys, at least, that do like Lady Gaga, especially around where I live, because I live in the country and people don't really like people who are different around here. Not very open-minded around where I live, so I watched it with a bunch of guys who criticized her the entire time. But nonetheless, my uncle, who is very country and doesn't like Lady Gaga, at the end he said, "Wow, I gotta admit, that was pretty cool." And I was like, "See? Told you, she's freaking cool." But yeah, she did it amazing. I thought it was so cool. I love the intro and the exit especially. Just like, I would love to be her in that moment. I would love to like jump off the stadium where the Super Bowl was being performed and just like catapult down to the stage. Like, that's just so awesome. And she's just awesome. And then she did an amazing catch at the end. It was just really, really cool. Like I said, I do have a whole video of me reacting to it over on my vlog channel if you want to go watch it there. But I did just want to mention it in this video. And so that's what I have to say. I love Gaga. Always have loved Gaga. Always will love Gaga. She's just amazing. She's so, so talented. And girl can sing. That's all I have to say. Girl can sing. Now moving on to what is going to be the main portion of this video, which is, of course, the Grammys, which were 2 weeks ago, today, actually. The Oscars are going on the TV behind me. I turned it off for this video, but the Oscars are going on right now. I don't really watch the Oscars because I don't really watch any of the movies. I have not seen a single movie that is nominated for an Oscar this year. Not a single one. I haven't seen any of them. Just don't keep up with movies as much as I do music. But anyways, getting into the Grammys, so many people won that were just amazing. Dolly Parton won an award in 2017. That just blows my mind. My Girl Pink was also nominated for that, and tweeted out, or not even tweeted, she posted on Instagram that she can now die a happy person because she lost an award to Dolly Parton. I thought that was really cool. Anyways, I wrote down some of my standout performances. The first one I have wrote down is Alicia Keys and Maren Morris. When I heard they were performing, I kind of figured they would be performing an Alicia Keys song because Alicia Keys is a little bit more popular than Maren Morris. But they actually sang Maren Morris's song once, and it was really good. First of all, their outfits, all the outfits at the Grammys were amazing. I just gotta say that, first of all. Everyone looked amazing, but I just thought it was cool seeing a pop star or soul singer, whatever you call Alicia Keys, R&B, I don't know what you consider her, pop, R&B, soul, a little bit of everything mixed. I just thought it was cool to see her singing a country song. Also, can we just talk about James Corden hosting? That was like the highlight of my night. Like the intro that he did where he fell down the steps, and like, he was just amazing. I thought he was so, so good. The carpool karaoke thing was my favorite thing ever. Little Blue Ivy was running around there. She was having a blast. She was probably one of my favorite people of the night, besides the top two that I will talk about at the end of this video. But she was just like so, so cute. I thought it was so funny. I also want to talk about how 21 Pilots won an award and accepted it in their underwear. I thought that was the funniest thing ever. Their award speech came in third on my list of my favorites. I thought the story behind it was pretty funny. I've actually said stuff like that to my friends before, so it kind of made me think a little bit about what I say. Not that I'll ever win a Grammy, but you know, if I do, I might have to do something silly like accept it in my underwear, so I gotta watch what I say. Ed Sheeran performed Shape of You, which, first of all, his two new singles, three now, that have been released off of his new album is amazing. They are phenomenal. That is what happens when you take a year off social media to just focus on your career, your music, and just write and travel. And he is just so, so talented. And he got up on stage with just, what was it, a piano, a loop pedal, a microphone, and a guitar, and he just did the whole performance himself. He is like a one-man band. Only Ed Sheeran can do something like that. Most people have to have a band behind them. Only Ed Sheeran can do that with just a loop pedal, a piano, a guitar, or a guitar, either or both, and just microphone, and just do your whole song by yourself. It's just crazy to me how talented he is. He's just so good. I love Ed Sheeran so much, as does everybody else in the world. It was such a simple performance, but so much talent was involved in it. It was so good. Next one I want to talk about is Katy Perry. She, first of all, I am loving blonde, short-haired Katy Perry. I don't know what it is about that, like, cut or color or style or whatever she is doing with her hair is just banging. Like, she is just rocking that hairstyle so, so much. And she performed Chained to the Rhythm, which everybody who watches my channel knows that I love Katy Perry. I loved the performance. I thought it was so cool how it was, like, the set was so cool, how it like rotated and had the fence, and so many different aspects of it was really, really cool. I loved her little like business suit that was white. I just thought it kind of complimented the hair a lot, and she just looks so cool. She was dancing around and, like, you know, it was just so cool. Katy Perry's just amazing. The next two performances I'm going to talk about are both of Bruno Mars performances. First of all, when he sang That's What I Like, he's just so cool. Like, the dance moves were on point, and he was doing the little, like, pelvic thrust, and, like, he's just so smooth and so, like, on point with every, like, move and every, like, he's just got, like, a cool, sexy vibe about him, about the way he moves. Just got, like, a swag about him. Like, he's very cool and smooth, but it's not, like, a douchey swag. It's, like, a, I'm cool, and I'm gonna hit this move right here, and I'm gonna do this right here, and I don't know, he's just so cool. And, guys, did you see J-Lo at the end of that performance when they came down, like, off the stage to the, like, little side stage there? He had said something about, like, I'm gonna break it down for you or something, and J-Lo was like, yeah, break it down, yeah, break it down. I just thought it was so funny that J-Lo did that. It made my day. I don't know if anybody else noticed that, but she was like, yeah, Bruno, break it down. And it was just, I don't know, it made me kind of laugh, and it was funny to me. I really liked Bruno Mars' performance of that. And then he did the Prince tribute, which was also amazing. I didn't realize how much him and Prince kind of look alike until they put him in, like, Prince's suit. It wasn't Prince's suit, but you know what I mean, like a Prince-type suit, and they kind of really look alike. I thought it was really, really good, and I don't know, Bruno's just so cool. I don't have any other word for Bruno but cool, and I know I've said that word, like, 1,000 times in this video already, but that's just the only word I think of when I think of Bruno Mars, is, like, smooth and cool. He's just cool. Another performance I want to talk about quickly is the Lucas Graham and Kelsea Ballerini mashup that they did. When it first started out, if you guys don't know, they did Peter Pan by Kelsea Ballerini, and they did 7 Years by Lucas Graham, and they kind of, like, did a mashup of it where they took turns kind of singing. And when they first started it, I was like, this is weird. After a while, after they kept singing it, and we're, like, playing with the melodies a little bit and, like, mixing them together, I kind of really liked it. I really like both of those songs separate, so mixing them together, though you really wouldn't think that they would go together, they kind of went together really well. Now back on the topic of Gaga, she performed with Metallica, and I thought, a lot of people criticize this, I thought it was fucking awesome. Like, I really, really thought that it was just an amazing performance, because they had some technical difficulties with the mic in the beginning, and I didn't really even notice at first. It took me a minute to realize. I thought they were still just, like, jamming out because it's Metallica, and I thought they were just doing what they wanted on the show, and then I realized that, oh, his mic's not working. I thought that it was really good. They controlled the technical difficulties and worked through them very well, and Lady Gaga went crowd surfing, which is just amazing to me. That's what I would want to do if I ever got to perform with Metallica. I would want to go crowd surfing. She looked like just straight up rocker. She didn't look like casual Gaga. She looked like a rocker babe. She was dancing. She could move. She was moving them hips, girl, and just getting it. And it was just, fire was all over the stage. It was just so cool. I really, really liked it. And then, of course, I have to mention the Bee Gees tribute, which included some of my favorite people. Demi Lovato, Tori Kelly, which, first of all, Tori Kelly was on, it still blows my mind when Tori Kelly is on the Grammys or on a performance, like a live show, a music award show, anything like that, because I watched Tori Kelly on YouTube way before she was famous. But Tori Kelly did the Bee Gees tribute, Little Big Town did it, and then Andra Day did it. And those are all, like, my favorite people, and it was so, so good. I thought it was cool, a cool mixture of people again, because those are people that come from a lot of different genres, and it was just really cool. I liked it. Carrie Underwood and Keith Urban performed The Fighter. I really, really, really like that song. I was happy, again, that a country artist got to perform on there. They usually have it, but I'm glad it was them. Carrie Underwood just looks fucking bomb all the time. I don't know how she does it. I swear that she just wakes up and looks flawless. She is like the Beyonce of country music. She is just flawless. There is nothing about her that is not flawless. Her voice is flawless, her face is flawless, her legs are flawless, every outfit that ever has been on her body is flawless. I just love her. And then Keith Urban is just like so cute, and he's a little Australian, and he's just, I don't know, he's so cute, and he's got such a good voice. He's an amazing guitarist, and I just thought it was a really good performance. I really like them. And then, of course, we have to talk about Beyoncé's performance, which everybody was freaking out about. I didn't think it was that good. I mean, it was good. It was Beyoncé. She was doing Beyoncé. But it was a very beautiful, boring performance. Somebody else described it as that. If you guys have ever watched That Chick Angel, she described it as her literally sitting in the most ghetto chair ever, because she spent so much money making sure that the audience was on an LSD trip. And that's basically what I thought it was. At first, I was very confused by it. I felt like I was like, when she had all the people like popping up around her on the screen, and it was just like, what is going on? Am I on drugs right now? But when she did actually perform after all that stuff was said, that kind of made sense if you listened to it, but also kind of didn't because of the things that were popping up around on the screen. It just kind of was a very weird performance to begin with, but when she actually did start singing and start the actual performance and not just like the weird LSD stuff, it was really, really good. She looked like a freaking goddess, first of all. I didn't like her performance completely because the beginning was a little weird for me. It was very artistic, I will give her that. But it was still just a little bit weird, a little bit of a weird artistic taste. But nonetheless, it's Beyoncé. She looked good. Her titties looked good. Let's be honest. We were all like, girl, how'd you get your titty looking like that with your pregnant belly? Like, obviously everybody thinks she looked good. She was looking like a Snapchat filter. I saw on Twitter somebody posted, she was just covered in gold, like Beyoncé should be, and it was just really cool. Again, she kind of gave us a little LSD trip there at the beginning, but she looked amazing. She sang amazing once she did sing and didn't just talk stuff off her head. It was Beyoncé doing what she does, and I can't say nothing bad about that. We all love Beyoncé. My second favorite person of the night, Chance the Rapper. First of all, I knew who he was, but I had never really listened to his music a whole lot. His acceptance speech, first of all, blew my mind. You do not hear very many people in music in general, but especially in rap music, get up there and thank God as hardcore as he did. But the majority of his acceptance speech was spent thanking God for giving him the talent, for everything that he has went through and everything he has been given in his life and all the success he's had. And I just thought that was so, so amazing. I don't really listen to a whole lot of rap music because I feel like it's all very negative for the most part. It's all about sex and drugs, and I feel like all rap music is basically the same because it all just talks about the same thing with a different beat and different words, basically. So I don't listen to a lot of it, but I did go and check him out afterwards, and he's so, so good. His performance there when he's saying "How Great Is Our God" plus one of his other songs, it was like a mix of the two. It was phenomenal. It had me in tears. I had chills. I was so blown away by him, and I really do like his music. I checked out some of his songs, and I really like that he raps about real stuff and not just sex and drugs and stuff like that that most rappers do. That's why Eminem is my favorite rapper, because he raps about real life stuff. And while, yes, the real life is depressing and a lot of Eminem's music is depressing, it's real, you know what I mean? It's real life situations that people go through, and not just breaking up with a girlfriend or doing drugs with a boyfriend or having sex with a, you know, it's real life situations, real life struggles that these people went through. And I just really, really liked him. I loved that performance with the choir behind him. It was beautiful. I freaking loved it. And now on to who everybody should be talking about if they haven't already, Adele. She blew me away. First of all, she opened the Grammys with Hello, which was everybody's song. Like, there is not a single person who didn't sing that song or get that song stuck in their head a million times in 2016, and it's still such a beautiful song. And then she did the George Michael tribute, which is probably what most people are talking about her, or were talking about when it happened. She started the tribute and they were some kind of sound, timing was off or something, and you know, just something went wrong there. And you could definitely tell, I'm still not sure exactly what went wrong, but you could tell there was just something that was off about it. And she literally stopped in the middle of her performance, said something, in a cuss word that they blurred out, that they bleeped out, and said, I need to start it again. I know it's a live show, but I need to start this performance again because I am not going to do this to George Michael. He deserves the best, and I'm going to restart this. And she did, and she killed it, and I have so much respect for her. First of all, I have always loved Adele, but that night she did what not very many performers would do. Most people would just push through it, but she didn't want to do that. She wanted to be the very best for George Michael, and she did it. She blew me away with that performance. I thought it was so strong and so brave, and she made me cry at the end of it when she was just standing there, like, she just, like, looked like she was gonna cry. She looked so sad, and I really wanted to just grab her and just hug her, just run up on stage and hug her, and I really wish somebody would have. If I would have been there, I would have attempted to and probably got escorted out by security, but I really just wanted somebody to go hug her because she looked so sad and so disappointed in her performance, and I thought it was amazing. I thought what she did was amazing, and I just love Adele in general. I've always loved her. And then she won the Record of the Year and Song of the Year, I believe it was. I don't remember exactly what two. The two that were announced at the end of the show that Beyoncé was also up for, and she literally broke her Grammy in half, gave a speech, a toast to Beyoncé, who is everybody's idol, and that was amazing. She told Beyoncé how she makes her friends feel strong and how that album was so good and so powerful and how much she loved and adored, and just, she said what everybody wants to say to Beyoncé, and she asked Beyoncé to be her mom, and then Faith Hill asked Beyoncé to be her mom, even though Faith Hill is older than Beyoncé, and it just was so amazing. And she literally broke her Grammy in half. I don't know if you guys saw the picture, but she literally broke her, she mean girled her Grammy and broke it in half and gave half of it to, it just was so incredible. I love Adele so much. She did a press conference afterwards, which I watched, and she was so funny and so real, and that's what I love about Adele. She's just so down to earth, so real. She cusses, she talks about drinking, she just is so real. She talks about sex in some of her interviews, if you watch. She is just so genuinely real to who she is. And I also forget how young Adele is. She's only like 4 or 5 years older than me, and she's so mature and so, I don't know, she's just so funny, so witty, she's so relatable, she's like Jennifer Lawrence, kind of, in a weird, quirky way. Jennifer Lawrence but can sing like a goddess. She's just so relatable. I love Adele so much. I think it would be so fun to go out with Adele for like a night of drinking, or go to like a club with Adele. I just think it would be so much fun. Or even just sit down and talk to her about life. I just adore her. If I could sit down with anybody, Adele would be one person on that list, as well as many other people. She was my favorite person of the night. I was like, yes, Adele, yes, yes, yes. I was so feeling the Adele vibes. And then I went and watched some of her live performances. I saw one performance where she was at a concert, she was like on tour, and the microphone, like the PA, completely shut off. There was no music for a period of time, and she was still singing and didn't realize it. And when she got done, the audience told her that it had cut out, and she started making jokes about it, and she said, well, everybody probably thought I was miming. She said, I guess it was a private show for you guys, and everybody that couldn't hear me thought I was miming, or lip syncing is what she meant. And she said, I wasn't lip syncing, was I? I wasn't. And she put the microphone down and to a girl in the audience, and the girl said no, and she said, see, people always say that I lip sync, but I I sing every fucking show. I sing live every fucking show. And she was, it was just so funny. And like, it was comedic, a comedic way to go about a technical difficulty. I don't know. She's just so amazing. I really feel bad for her because last Grammy she had some technical difficulties with the piano and the microphone fell on the strings. And then this year she also had a technical difficulty. So hopefully next year she will have a better Grammys experience. But nonetheless, Adele is amazing, 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 amazing. I love her. I can't believe, I always thought that she, I always put her above Beyonce, but I never thought that the rest of the world would vote for her over Beyonce, because Beyonce is kind of an icon. But for me, Adele is a little bit higher on that list, just because she's so, I don't know. Anyways, I have rambled a whole lot in this video. It's really late at night, and yeah, so I am going to go. I will be filming another Music Monday next week, so be prepared for that. And also subscribe to my channel if you guys want to see a room tour and some declutter videos coming up. So, because those will be what is coming up in March for me. Some Music Mondays, some declutters, some room tours, some different like cleaning, rearranging type stuff. And yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know what you thought of the Grammys and the Super Bowl down below, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys!